Hello again, and welcome back to the card mat. I'm a bit scared to touch these cards because these are my spider cards, and as you can see, I'm scared of spiders, so I'm a bit afraid to touch them, but I'll give it a go. Look, oh, scary. Right, this is my variation on a very old trick. And I'll show you what the old trick looks like once I've gone through doing this one. So you start off with a borrowed deck of cards, but these aren't borrowed, these are actually mine. Keep your eyes off. Your own deck, and you make sure they get a bloody good shuffling. Right, once you're happy that they've been shuffled, or your spectator is happy that they've shuffled them enough, you spread them out and you say, pick one of them cards, please, thank you very much. So then they proceed to pick one of them cards, just as you had asked them. You then pick all the cards back up again, and you say, there is the card you selected. Well done. Thank you very much, and give us me check. No, you don't. You say, there's the card you picked. Look at that, you actually picked an ace, you picked the ace of clubs. Good job it wasn't the ace of spades, because that's got a bloody big spider on. Then you get their card, and you proceed to lose their card right into the middle of the packet, just like what I've gone and done there. So you get their card lost into the packet, and then what you do is you give the packet a series of little cuts, just like that. There was one little cut, and that was one little cut, wasn't it? And then you give them another little cut, just like that. So you've now gone and give the cards two cuts. Then what you do is you take, how many was that? That was four, that was five. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. That's 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. That's 15. I can't count all the way up. I've got to do it. I've only got 5 fingers on the hands. That's how I count. Right. So you end up getting 16 cards. What you then do is put the 16 cards down into 4 series of 4 and make them into a nice little cross, just like that. So you got that one, and that one. And then you got that one, and that one. So you end up with 4 little crosses on the table and a pack of cards, which I'll move a bit further out the way. Right, you then say, I want you to do us a big favour and cut down on the amount of cards we've actually got. So pick any 2 packs and we'll get rid of them. But whatever you do, don't pick these 2. So they go, okay, and they'll pick it. No, they won't. They'll be funny. They'll go, well, I'll take one of them and I'll take one of them. You go, okay, we'll get rid of them. Straighten up. Make sure it easy going back on the pack. So, there, we've now got 2 piles of cards. Please, pick one pile so we can get rid of another pile. And you go, we'll have that pile. And you go, okay, you want that pile, we'll get rid of this pile. So we get rid of that pile. You then end up with 4 cards. And if you spread them out like that, you get a nice little square in the middle and it resembles a rose. Well, actually, it doesn't resemble a rose. But it looks nice. Then you say, do us a favour, we want to get rid of some of these cards as well. Please pick 2 of these cards. So they say, we'll have these 2. And you go, okay, we'll keep them and we'll get rid of them 2. That then leaves us with 2 cards. Just to confuse you slightly, I'll give the cards a bit of a mixing up, just like this. And once I finish mixing them up, I want you to pick 1 card. And they go, okay, we'll have that card. And you go, so you've got bye-bye to that card. You then recap on what you've done. We had a pack of cards which I borrowed off somebody, but this pack I didn't because they were my own. They then got a good shuffling, as they did, well, you've seen. And then the card was picked and the card was put and lost and cut a couple of times. And then 16 cards were taken and you eliminated all the way down to this one card. And I always told you I could do that. I was only messing with you the times. And the one card that we actually end up with just happens to be your card, would you believe it? I don't. I'm amazed how that actually happened, I am. I thought I really confused myself on that. But anyway, there we go. Thank you very much for watching. Glad you enjoyed it. Well, I hope you enjoyed it. Yeah, I'm getting a bit presumptuous there. Right, do you want to see how that was done? Or the way I done that? Well, tell you what. First off, I'll tell you how it's normally done. You get the card and you put it into the middle. And as it goes into the middle, you catch a pinky break on it. And then you're just doing your double undercut, aren't you? To bring their card right back to the top. Right, any way you want to get it back to the top. I use my favourite way of doing it, as you're quite aware. So you work their card to the top. Then what you proceed to do is deal down 4 piles of 4 cards, knowing that the very first card you deal is their card. Yeah, they can get onto it, especially if you're doing it to a fellow magician, but I'm not a magician. I'm just an idiot who plays with cards. If you're doing it to somebody who knows about cards, they'll know that that is their card, right? What I do to spice things up a little bit is I firstly get a pinky pull down, obviously not as big as that, but I get a pinky pull down on the bottom card and turn it into a thumb break so it looks like that. Then I cut a small chunk off the top and put it to the bottom and drop that one card onto the top of there. Split that in half, pull that across, swing that over and pull that on the top, which then puts their card second to the top. I then, if you noticed, if you were watching very closely, I then proceeded to do another cut, so I'd done the exact same thing. Done a pinky pull down on the bottom card, chained it into the thumb break, broke part of the packet off, put it to the bottom, dropping that card onto the top of it, broke that packet in half, swiveled that one, and turned that onto the top. That then put their card there to the top. Yeah. Then I counted cards. I went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I know their card is third from the bottom, and I put them down. Then I went 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 again, and put them down. I can only count on fives because I've only got five fingers on my hand. It gets confusing if I go past five. So you count another five, and then you need one more card, which you drop onto the top, like very kindly just done for me. So now you know that the third to last card you're going to put down is going to be their card. So again, you deal down your four piles. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and you know that that was their card there. So magician's force to eliminate all the packets, so they've all gone. You spread these cards out, knowing that that one there is still their card. And again, magician's force, or in my case, person who plays with cards force, to get rid of them three, or get rid of two of them. And then you do a little bit of shuffling, but you've got to make sure that you keep your eye on this card here, because you know that that card there was their card, but do not move it around with your finger staying on the top, because they will get suspicious. And they eliminate another card, and then you turn over and show them that's their card. But hey, there we go. Right. So that was the way it's normally done first off, and then I'm just showing you the way I just done it then. There is another way you can do it, and it'll change every time, and it's pretty clever. Well, I think it's pretty clever anyway. Right, what you do is you do the same thing, get them to pick a card, and it goes into the middle, and their card gets weighed up to the top of the package, like I've just gone and done like that. And then, here's where you vary it. You take off as many cards as you want to. You know you need 16, so you can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and put it down. So you know their card now 7th from the end. If it's 7th from the end, it means you've got to put another 9 on the top, doesn't it? So that's 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. And just to show you, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So 9 cards have gone onto the top of it. So you know when you've dealt down 9 cards, you know the next one is their card. And you have to keep your eye on that. And if you didn't want it as the 9th card, if you didn't want it there, you could go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and a 1. And now you know the fifth card from the end is going to be their card. So you're dealing 4 there, and you're dealing 4 there, and you're dealing 4 there, and you know that that one then is going to be their card before you put down the last pile. So the card can vary the position it is. And if you want to be a real smarty pants, you can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and put it down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 and put it down. So now you know that the 7th card you deal is going to be their card, which puts it into that pile. So you can do it on as many people as you want to and vary the position and the outcome of actually where the card's going to be when you get to show it. As you got to at the end anyway. But there you go. I hope you enjoyed it. A couple of variations on doing this very, very old trick, which will confuse a lot of people. I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly do. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you again soon.